All right, as we prepare our second contest here tonight, Dean Malenko and Jushin Thunder Liger. And we're gonna talk a little bit more about Ray the Crippler Stevens, Bobby, in just a few moments, but let's take this opportunity to announce that Otani, the new WCW Cruiserweight Champion, won that title in Japan. And wrestling fans, check your local listings, because on May 18th, that weekend, on Worldwide Wrestling, you will see the debut of the new WCW Cruiserweight Champion. And Otani will defend that title. He is scheduled to defend that title at Slamboree. And there you see Jushin Thunder Liger. He was here in our debut broadcast of WCW Monday Nitro, live from Minneapolis. And he is back again. And this cruiserweight division is going to heat up. It is going to get hot. It'll get hot fast. And you're going to see some exciting, high-flying action in this newly established division with a new champion, Otani, at the top of the list.
And there's my good business partner, Sonny Ono at ringside. Very smart Japanese gentleman.
He's the equivalent of the United States' Jimmy Hart is about all.
No, he's not. He's more like a Donald Trump. The man puts big deals together. Big businessman.
Calling up a hookup into a side headlock by Dean Malenko. Head scissors escape by Jushin Thunder Liger. Both men up very quick. And you're going to see a tremendous amount of technical wrestling here, scientific wrestling, if you will. Drop, toe hold, take down into a front face lock, sit out and turn into a hammer lock, Jushin Thunder Liger. Liger in control of the action, riding his opponent here in the center of the ring. Ranking on the arm. You are also going to see a tremendous amount of high flying action as Liger working on the wrist and the elbow. Pressure points in two areas here, actually three. The shoulder, rotator cuff, elbow, and the wrist. Matt Kip up. And into a reversal, Dean Malenko, the man of 1,000 holes. Nice reversal here. Kip up, single leg pickup, and a cover. Not even a one count.
Well, Eric,
this is, I know, Steve, I know you were looking forward to this matchup, but I want to point out, I just got word, the Macho Man Randy Savage escorted from the building by local law enforcement. Back leg round kick.
Well, you know as well as I do, something has to be done about Savage. It's gone too far.
Wait a minute, the crowd reacting here. The Nature Boy.
No sooner did you say Macho was out of the building than we have an appearance by Ric Flair.
Yeah, something tells me that the Nature Boy Ric Flair was waiting for the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Look at this. Tux, he was waiting for the Macho Man.
Well, that would make a beautiful top on a wedding cake, wouldn't that? Yeah. Boy, is Flair decked out? Got one of those $5,000 Armani tucks on, and look at that.
Oh, did you see that?
Beautiful gowns.
One, two, and a kick out by Dean Malenko. Wow, the Nature Boy Ric Flair and his entourage, if you will, of women, take their seat in the VIP section. Jushin Thunder Liger and Dean Malenko, the man of 1,000.
Oh! He's out.
One, two, and...
Oh, no.
Dean Malenko able to roll the shoulder as the manager, Sonny Ono, complains that, oh, all right, we've got to take a break. We'll be back with more action. Jushin Thunder Liger, Dean Malenko, oh, one! No way, no way.
Did they give me a bottle of bubbly or a couple of glasses over here? Some with some straws in those little hats.
Look at this, welcome back, and we're looking at the Nature Boy Ric Flair, woman and Miss Elizabeth continuing to spend the Macho Man's money, this time in the VIP section.
And you know what Flair told me? Not only are they spending Macho Man's money on the champagne and the caviar, they popped for the candelabras and everything. Macho Man paid for everything. What a guy, huh?
I hope he can afford bail.
Well, when you're sitting there watching a match like that, you have to call it wrestling. You can't call it wrestling.
Well, Savage is in the back of Adam 12 right now while Flair's out enjoying the champagne.
In the meantime, Dean Malenko taking care of business inside of the ring with Jushin Thunder Liger. And the man of 1,000 holes, Snapmare Takeover, has been controlling the pace of this match for the last 2 or 3 minutes and now going for a submission, working over the leg.
You know, Orkwin made a statement about Malenko. He says the man's got ice water running through his veins. The man shows no emotion. The man's eyes are just focused on it. Well, it tells me the man's a professional. He's done his homework. He's not in that ring to look cute, look flashy, make friends. He's in there to make the big money and win, that's all. I take my hat off to Dean Malenko.
Without question, the newest, most exciting talent from all over the world coming to WCW. And stay tuned. because throughout the month of May, and particularly in June, things are going to get very interesting indeed in WCW. This is, as they say, where the big boys play.
Do you see what he's doing there, Weasel? He's working on that leg. We talked in the, at the top of this thing about how Jushin Liger likes to fly around. He gets up on the ropes, but when you don't have any legs, baby, there's not very much flying to do.
Well, that's right. He's got the man from Japan there with the horns grounded pretty well. I don't know who to pick for right here that I like as my favorite. Malenko, I like his style, but then again, I'm on the table. I mean, I was going to say,
Sonny Ono pays your part.
Oh, he doesn't pay anything. I didn't mean pay.
Oh, look at this. He takes me out.
He takes me out for a sushi.
Is that the big business deals he was talking about?
Irish whip reversal inside of the ring. Jump back elbow by Jushin. Thunder Liger catches DeMalenko coming off the ropes. 1-2 count by Jushin Thunder Liger. And this thing has been going back and forth.
Oh!
Heel kick right to the head.
Right between the eyes.
And now Jushin Thunder Liger setting Malenko up. Malenko in trouble here. He is prone on that top turnbuckle. He is vulnerable.
He's a man of a thousand holes. Watch Liger.
Drop kick.
He could be in trouble.
And Liger, aerial attack while Malenko is outside of the ring. And Liger catches.
To the floor from the top rope.
That high-risk maneuver put a little ding on the top of his head too, didn't it?
Bent one of his horns.
Both men took a tremendous impact there, and that's why they call it a high-risk maneuver. Jushin Thunder Liger.
And that's what this cruiserweight's all about.
Oh, look at this. Dean Malenko, 1-2, and Liger set up there. Did not get him, 1-2. And this thing has been going back and forth. The man of the thousand holes has used up about 680 of them here.
This thing could go all night if these guys keep rolling on top of each other.
Irish whip up and over. Right hand attempt by Malenko, blocked and countered by Liger. Malenko, a couple right hands in the midsection, puts the brakes on Liger. Both men now more concerned about keeping their balance. This could be a disaster for either one of them.
What is he going to do with him?
Oh! Oh, I've never seen it before. Off the top rope, you talk about a gut buster.
He's not going anyplace. Take your time getting up, Toots. You're going to be there a while.
Talk about a double hernia. That guy's got some holes in his gut right now.
Dean, man, and a counter by Liger. 1-2.
He got him.
Oh, man, he almost
did. He get him?
No way. He almost had him. I love this action. The WCW Cruiserweight Division. You'll see action like this each and every week. Standing switch, go behind. Knee to the midsection. Chicken wings. Oh. He got him, he got him.
He got him, is right.
Now this is amazing. The flexibility of these athletes. Anybody else in the world hits a mat like that, they have something broke.
We'll be back with more action